Prevent disasters, discrimination at the workplace. It gets a role, but mental health. It gets a role, yo. But mental health, yo.
My name is Nancy Amanda Bali, Mrs. But people mostly call me Auntie Nancy. I am a trained nurse. And I am someone with mental health problems. I know you would want to know some of my problems or how my problems started. If so, please follow me. I started having my problems after I married. Yes, my husband, I loved him, I trusted him completely. But later on, he left me for another woman. That's how my problem started. I felt ashamed and have to leave the place and come down to my family's house. The second thing that helped increase my problem was my family. I love my family and I trusted them. But when I came to them after my issue with my husband, they neglected me, abandoned me, stigmatized me. That led me to distrust everybody in the family. Started to shut myself up from everybody. After my family, the next thing that aggravated my problem was the hospital setup. As I said earlier, I'm a trained and qualified nurse and also a trained counselor for HIV and AIDS, and I worked at a renowned hospital. I got ill at one point in time and I was admitted at the hospital. They did several tests on me and they later told me that I was HIV positive. But later I proved it was the wrong result. But they terminated my services in the hospital. My colleagues all neglected me and started sharing false rumors about me. So the hospital helped increase my problem. After there, you see this symbol is an empty pocket. I was a breadwinner. I'm the breadwinner of my family. I have 2 kids. When I was sick, I couldn't afford money to provide anything, not even a basic breakfast. So the bus pocket, this bus empty pocket symbolizes my problem. It increases it because when I see my children, I saw myself, I don't have anything to support myself. It increases my problem. Last but not the least is the boiling tea kettle. You know that as something boils in the tea kettle, it increases. So when I have lost all confidence in all these people, my family, my neighbors, my colleagues, all of them, I just shut myself up and isolated myself, not talking to anybody. I just sat there and just the problem just increases. Nobody talks to me. They just left me on by myself. I cannot talk to anybody. So this is these are some of the problems that led to my mental illness. Now I can share with you what helped me. I have some. First and foremost is medication and psychosocial support. It was not until I was taken to the Connaught Hospital, the mental health unit, where the nurse there, the mental health nurse, started giving me psychotropic drugs and counseling regularly. She did this for several times. Then I started opening up. I started to gain confidence and trust someone because she recognized that I'm someone. She treated me with dignity and respect. So that was the first step to my recovery process. From there, I symbolized the Bible. As a true Christian, a Jehovah's Witness for that matter, I used to read the Bible when I was alone. And I have 2 stories that interest me most. That is the story of Job and that of the prodigal son. Job was afflicted with so many illnesses, so many problems. He was neglected and abandoned, but he never left God. And at the end, he was rewarded. The prodigal son, he squandered his father's money and everything. But when he recognizes that he has done wrong, he came to see to repent back. And when his father saw him from afar, he went and embraced him and made a feast for him. So those two stories helped me to realize that all is not lost. If no one is there to support me, there is God to support me. So the Bible helped me also to be progressive in my recovery. Thirdly, see, this group is a self-help group. The nurse at the Connors Unit Hospital, she encouraged me to join a self-help group. It comprises of people with lived experiences like myself. And we meet once a week, a month. And there are people expresses their experiences, how they get their problems. So from there I started regaining confidence bit by bit until after someone expresses her experiences, I experienced them. That triggered me to open up, share my experience. So that also was a step to progress for me. Next, I use the Corona outbreak lockdown. Why I use Corona outbreak lockdown? During that time, my eldest son usually works, before that time, he usually works out of the house. But because of my condition, he asked for him to be working at home, work from home. So during that time, he used to talk to me. We shared experiences. He encourages me. He supports me. And that also helped me to recover speedily. And last but not the least is the Mental Health Coalition Secretariat. This umbrella body of coalition is a great help to me because I came here and I volunteered to work at the coalition. The first day of work, when I met with all the people in the workplace, I just saw them as a family because they treated me with human dignity and respect. I felt that I had known them all before. I felt relaxed. I felt at home. So since that day, I started working. I knew I had found a family. And up till now, I have that family. So if I could stop so far, this has to be some of the experience of my lost and found. Open ears and listen very carefully.